China with its 1,300,400,000,000 executes around 2,000 men per year. And we are also, Singapore, 4 million inhabitants, executes, I think, between 500 and 1,000. No? Now then I ask them, because it's true, but there is no crime there, you know. Like, I mean, no crime in the murders, violence, very little, no? Like, how do, and they told me, now I come to your point, yes, that you get that penalty for two reasons, mainly. Smuggling drugs and illegal traffic with foreigners, importing them or whatever. It's death penalty, no? On the other hand, some of their tough legislation, I almost liked it. They told me that it's now no longer that they beat you. Even if you are a big public person, you know, this proverbial, what happens if you spit your chewing gum? Mm-hmm. And it's true, I loved it. Like, my son wanted a chewing gum. I had to go to a pharmacy and negotiated there. They had to call somewhere up there. I like it, my God. And then, you know what I was told? It's wonderful. If you are caught spitting it out, now they liberalize their law. 10 years ago, you were beaten with a cane. Now it's first time, $500, their dollars, which is half the dollar, I think, US. Second time, $1,000. And third time, I love this. You have to wear a special T-shirt where it says your name, of both sides in big letters, I was polluting environment, and dressed like that, for 1 week, you have to clean shit on the main shopping street for 10 hours a day. I'm sorry, I don't know why I agree with it. What I discovered, but let me tell you, I'm sorry, but you will get all the fucking texts. Let me tell you my most beautiful adventure, which will totally confirm. I was with my two pervert sons, I described them to you, no? And driving by a taxi, and we saw there in front of a big building some 50 workers sitting down. And I asked the taxi driver, with my naive leftist coach, what's this, a demonstration, a strike? The driver started to laugh so much that he had to stop the strike, demonstration. They told me, if they just think about this, the police would be there, all would have been deported, whatever, arrested. No, he told me, they are there waiting, because it was 5 in the afternoon, for the truck, not bus, truck, to take them to their, what you describe as their half prison, half military barracks. But then I told him naively, but my God, what if they want to do a shopping? And the taxi driver, who was a native Singaporean, told me such charming naivety, but they are here to work. He didn't get it, like, why should they shop? They are here to work, you know? And then he told me, no, but they are not inhuman. Once a week, under guidance, they are allowed 2 hours shopping here. I know, they are, although I must say again, they are much, much better than Arab Emirates. If you look at that, you still, you know, it's nonetheless a kind of a fascism with a relative human face. I mean, compared with, again, as I said, Emirates. Because there, again, the exploitation is breathtaking. And to a big surprise of me, the most exploited there are not Filipinos or Indonesians. The lowest on the ladder in Qatar, when I was, they told me, are Nepalese men. And they are the ones who, in 50 degrees, had to do all time those high-rise buildings, and they are, of course, falling down like flies and so on, no? And I asked them, still I find mysterious, why did they pick up Nepalese to do that? The only explanation I have is this stupid association. They think Nepal, Himalaya, big mountains, used to. No. This, if you are looking for a real nightmare, no, look for that. But what I'm saying is nonetheless that I'm not making fun of Singapore, because it's a real challenge, my God. As we all know, remember this. When he started his reforms, Deng Xiaoping went to Singapore, was fascinated and said this should be the model for all China. And China is basically modeling itself on Singapore, even religiously. So this is why you get a totally wrong impression when you read just about that Falun Gong or whatever. The communists in China are now, they only worry about who controls the religious organizations. Of course, they were worried about Falun Gong or about Christians who are still, who still recognize Pope, because, you know, they are sensitive. They don't want a strong organization within China subordinated to a foreign power. This is also their problem with Tibetan Buddhism and so on. But, for example, my God, try to be critical of Confucianism today in China. I was, and I was attacked. Like, you know, who am I to talk, and so on and so on. I mean, if you play this, what they call patriotic religion, it's fully supported, and for obvious reasons, the same as in Singapore. They know very well of the destroying, disintegrating impact of this capitalist explosion. And their idea is that precisely the only, they know very well also that the old communist bullshit, party solidarity, communists, will not work. So they are well aware that this traditional Confucian respect for the older family structure is the only way to retain at least a minimum of social